So when I'm in the eye clinic, I hear a lot of my patients say things like, "Doc, my eyes are so bad that I'd be legally blind without my glasses." But that's not what legal blindness really means. And I know people think that if they went blind, it would be like having the lights turned off in a room, and they'd be just left in darkness all day. But in reality, about 80% of people with legal blindness still have some form of usable vision. So what does it mean to be blind versus legally blind? Well, in honor of World Sight Day, today we're talking about what is legal blindness, showing how people with low vision may still see and experience their world, as well as highlighting some of the new tools and technologies that help people who are living with vision loss. Let's take a look. This video is made possible with support from the Orcam MyEye, the world's most advanced assistive technology device for visual impairment. Hello and welcome, this is Dr. Allen here from the Dr. Eye Health Show, and on this channel we post a lot about education regarding eye diseases, their treatments, vision products, as pretty much everything regarding to eyesight, and that includes talking about vision loss and blindness. So what is legal blindness? Well, in most countries in the world, including here in the United States, there is a legal definition that constitutes what legal blindness is. Legal blindness is when somebody has central visual acuity, meaning their central vision, what is straight ahead of them, is 20/200 or less in his or her better seeing eye with correction. That means even with the best pair of glasses, the best contacts or surgery, the very best they can see is 20/200 or worse. Just for example, in comparison, if somebody is sitting in the exam room here and they're looking at the chart on the wall, this is what a 20/20 letter would look like. But 20/200 is this size. That is a big difference. And again, with legal blindness, that means you can't see any better than that with any pair of glasses, contacts, anything. So if you're somebody like myself who, without my glasses or contacts on, I know I can't see even a 20/400 letter, which is twice as bad as the 20/200, but the fact that I can put my glasses on and I can see 20/20 and 20/15 even, that means I do not have legal blindness, because my vision can be corrected. But there is another part of the definition of legal blindness, and that has to do with somebody's side vision. Meaning if somebody's ability to see off to their far sides is reduced, then they may also have legal blindness. The standard definition typically talks about if somebody, even if they can see really well, they can see 20/20 letters straight ahead of them, but their peripheral vision is only 20 degrees or less, then they also fit the definition of legal blindness. You can even try at home closing an eye and covering an eye with a little hand like this, just looking through a tiny little pinhole, and yeah, I can't imagine moving around and trying to get through my day like that. It is just not easy, to say the least. And I like that the definition addresses both acuity and the visual field, because with different types of eye conditions, it can be challenging to understand how some people with vision loss can still see some things, but still not see other things. And I think it's tough because a lot of us do think of blindness as, again, having the lights shut off, but for most eye diseases, because it hits the eye in different ways, it also presents with different types of vision loss. Just for example, like somebody with macular degeneration, these individuals will lose their central vision. So looking straight ahead of them is very difficult, making it hard for them to read or recognize families' faces, but it also leaves some of their peripheral vision. Where you can contrast to somebody who has glaucoma, where those individuals usually still keep some of their central vision, but they lose their peripheral vision, and it slowly becomes more and more in to eventually they just have like a tunnel vision effect. Other common conditions such as diabetic retinopathy, those individuals not only have usually very blurred vision, but they can also have complete blank spots, either in part or covering their entire visual field. Or with the condition of cataracts, which thankfully is an easily treatable condition with surgery these days, but still, across globally, it is one of the most common causes of blindness, and this can cause not only extremely blurred vision, but it can cause foggy and glare type eyesight changes that can be really debilitating. And then different eye and brain injuries, as well as other genetic conditions, can cause major sources of vision loss as well. Interestingly enough, here in the eye clinic, we don't label people as being blind. We first try to measure, even in extreme vision loss, if they're able to detect motion. So we may measure it as being hand motion at 5 feet, or we'll go as far as detecting if somebody can have light perception. So even though if they can't see my hand moving, they can at least say that they're able to detect light in a dark room. And we'll note that as having LP for light perception. And when somebody truly is blind and they cannot see anything, we note that as having NLP, no light perception. And I always thought that that would make probably the best vanity plate to have on your car license plate would be to have NLP-OU, which would be eye care terms for no light perception in both eyes. Nobody except for people who work in eye clinic would probably get that, but I just think it's funny, and that's my sense of humor. Now, dealing with vision loss is really difficult for either yourself, if you ever have to go through this, or maybe a family member. It can be scary, and a lot of people even feel very just hopeless about their eyesight and what their future holds for them. But thankfully, there are whole subspecialties in eye care and other services that are completely dedicated to helping people with vision loss, low vision, and legal blindness. Low vision specialists, eye doctors, and therapists really work together to help not only prescribe magnifiers and other vision aids, but also with rehabilitation to help people really navigate the world around them and become as independent as possible in functioning in their world. And if you, a friend or a family member, is kind of facing vision loss right now for any reason, and you're just not sure where to start to find these sort of helpful services, at the very least, I'll put some links in the description below so that you can find those and at least begin your journey. And with low vision and services for the blind, the earlier people get introduced to these services, this help, the better it is. Because if you're just starting to lose vision, it's easier to learn and adapt new technologies, techniques, and everything to really adjust to kind of how your future may be. Historically, eye doctors in the field of low vision are really masters at understanding optics and figuring the right amount of magnification and how to use those magnifying aids to help people maximize what little vision they still have left. But thankfully, in this world of modern technology that we have, we're starting to see new tools that go well beyond just magnification to help people see and function. For example, probably the number one thing I hear people with vision loss and legal blindness request that they wish they could do is that of reading, which is where new technology such as the Orcam MyEye comes in. And Orcam is the sponsor of today's video, but I wanted to work with them in this because I find their technology can help so many people that are facing vision loss, and I really just wanted to bring their technology to people's attention. The Orcam MyEye is a device that helps people with low vision, no vision, and even people with reading disabilities like dyslexia be able to read from books, magazines, computer screens, or really just almost anything. The device only weighs about an ounce, it's about the size of your finger, and it attaches to pretty much any pair of glasses. And the digital camera on the device is able to take a snapshot of its surroundings and read directly to you. Speaking the text directly to your ears or wirelessly to headphones or even like a Bluetooth speaker. It can even recognize objects and people's faces.
Dr. Allen.
I've actually been testing out the Orcam MyEye myself, and it is something that I even recommend or bring up to my patients in the clinic who would benefit from it, particularly people who struggle with or have a desire for more independence with reading. But I will say it is pretty amazing and impressive to see where technology is today and to think about where it could be going to in the future for not just people who still have good eyesight, but especially for people who may be struggling with their vision. And again, if you want to check out more information about the Orcam MyEye, I'll put links in the video description below so you can check out their website and learn a little bit more. But I do find it amazing to reflect back and just be grateful for things as simple as eyeglasses, because without these technologies of glasses or the existence of previous eye care professionals that came before me, where would we be? Because again, without these technologies, many of us would be legally blind. So do me and yourself a favor today, in honor of World Sight Day, reflect on just being grateful for the eyesight that you do have, for your ability to perceive colors and light. And if you and your family have not had eye exams within the last year, I strongly encourage you to schedule one to get your eyes checked, even if you think your vision is fantastic. Again, there are many eye diseases out there that sneak up on you and you don't realize your vision is changing until it's too late. I always keep reminding myself that even though making this channel and making these videos is a lot of work, I figure if I can just help one person in the world save their vision or see a little bit better, then it's all worth it. Otherwise, I hope you enjoyed this video. If you did and it helped you out, hit the like button for us. Subscribe to the channel if you want to keep learning about eyesight and keeping your eyes healthy. Otherwise, again, this is Dr. Alan here from the Dr. Eye Health Show. Keep an eye on it, and we'll see you in the next one.